Most of the things we've dealt with in terms of series, we've restricted ourselves to things with only positive terms. In general, that's because weird things can happen when we start throwing in negatives. But if we kind of control the way we put in negatives, there's a lot we can do with this. In particular, what we're going to deal with is something what we call an alternating series. And all an alternating series is, it's a series where the individual terms alternate between positive and negative. I mentioned this in some of my discussion on previous videos. If you have one of these things where you've got both positives and negatives, things can kind of cancel out. That means that things tend to go towards zero a little bit easier than they do otherwise. Typically, one of these things is written, it'll have either a negative 1 to the n or a negative 1 to the n plus 1 factor in the terms, because that's what makes it go back and forth between positive and negative. And then we'll typically write it as that factor times something that's always positive. That way we just don't need to worry about it not being alternating if the an somehow is sometimes positive and sometimes negative. Under those conditions, if we've got an alternating series, it's actually really easy for this thing to converge. We have something called the alternating series test. And the basic idea is, suppose we've got an alternating series, we've got one of these negative 1 to the n's, and while the theorem's written with negative 1 to the n, it doesn't change thing if it was a negative 1 to the n plus 1. The whole point, though, is that we've got one of these alternating things, and just like I was saying before, the non-sign part is always positive. And then the other thing is that these things are eventually non-increasing, so that we might have a finite number of terms up front where things don't work, but always, since we're talking about infinite versus finite, a finite number of terms don't really change anything. So at some point, the number part of this is getting smaller, or at least not getting bigger. Further, the limit of those terms has to be zero. Under those conditions, the series converges. The way I like to think about this is that if there's any chance of an alternating series converging, it does. Because we know if this last part isn't true, by the divergence test, the series diverges. So, and the other thing is this middle part is pretty much, not 100%, but pretty much, if this bottom thing, part 3, holds, number 2 is pretty much going to happen. There's some weird things where it can't, but most things that we're talking about, if the individual terms go to 0, that means they're non-increasing. Anyway, so if that's true, basically, that series automatically converges. So let's take a look at, it's a couple of examples, but this is honestly super, super easy to use. We've got an alternating series here. This part is always positive. And 1 over n plus 1 to the 3 halves is always going to be less than 1 over n to the 3 halves. Because that's true, we know we've got this non-increasing thing. And then if we take a look at the limit of just the positive part, as n goes to infinity of 1 over n to the 3 halves, that's 0. There we go. Automatically, we've got an alternating series. It's non-increasing. The limit of the individual terms is 0. Bam. This thing converges. Now, what about this one? Well, if I look at this, it's a little bit hard to see that the terms are non-increasing, but I actually don't even need to worry about that Because if I look at the limit as n goes to infinity of the non-sine part of that thing, that limit's 1. As soon as that limit's 1, we say, okay, the alternating series test doesn't apply, but the divergence test does. The individual terms diverge, or the individual terms don't go to 0. Because the individual terms don't go to 0, that means that series diverges. So, at the most basic level, alternating series are super easy to analyze. They're incredibly easy to figure out if they converge or diverge. In fact, we're going to find out here in another couple of videos that even when they converge, they have some nice properties that you don't get otherwise.